I forgot to tell you what happened the day the minister called here. It was the funniest thing I ever saw. I said to Marilla, if Anne had been here, wouldn't she have had a laugh? Even Marilla laughed. You know, he's a very short, fat little man with bow legs. Well, that old pig of Mr. Harrison's, the big, tall one, had wandered over here that day again and broke into the yard and got into the back porch, unbeknownst to us. And it was there when the minister appeared in the doorway. It made one wild bolt to get out, but there was nowhere to bolt except between them bow legs. So there it went, and being as it was so big and the minister so little, it took him clean off his feet and carried him away. His hat went one way and his cane another, just as Marilla and I got to the door. I'll never forget the look of him, and that poor pig was near scared to death. I'll never be able to read that account in the Bible of the swine that rushed madly down the steep place into the sea without seeing Mr. Harrison's pig careering down the hill with that minister. I guess the pig thought he had the old boy on his back instead of inside of him. I was thankful the twins weren't about. It wouldn't have been the right thing for them to have seen a minister in such an undignified predicament. Just before they got to the brook, the minister jumped off, or fell off. The pig rushed through the brook like mad and up through the woods. Marilla and I run down and help the minister get up and brush his coat. He wasn't hurt, but he was mad. He seemed to hold Marilla and me responsible for it all, though we told him the pig didn't belong to us and had been pestering us all summer. Besides, what did he come to the back door for? You'd never have caught Mr. Allen doing that. It'll be a long time before we get a man like Mr. Allen. But it's an ill wind that blows no good. We've never seen hoof or hair of that pig since, and it's my belief we never will.